Robert McRae and Paul Costa's five-factor model of personality is a hierarchical organization of personality traits in terms of five basic dimensions: extroversion, agreeableness, conscientiousness, neuroticism, and openness to experience.
This first came into existence in 1936, wherein two psychologists formed a list of 4,500 terms relating to personality traits, which was narrowed down to 16 in the 1940s. Robert McRae and Paul Costa then created the model consisting five primary factors of personality. It is regarded as the most widely accepted theory of personality today.
Our personality is what we really are at heart, and it is something we share with all of humanity. A quote from Robert R. McRae, PhD. This begs the question, what defines a personality? Is it a fixed set of standards that can be measured, or is it merely a generalization of a person's characteristics? This presentation will expand on why the students believe in Robert McRae and Paul Costa's five-factor model of personality. The model will be summarized and elaborated on, as it is able to provide a framework which attempts to gain a deeper understanding on the development of the psychological behavior and experience of individuals.
The first factor is neuroticism. Likened to emotional instability, this trait measures irritability and moodiness in one's behavior. Those that score high in this trait are perceived as moody and irritable, and often feel anxious, insecure, and self-pitying. They are prone to excessive sadness and low self-esteem, while those that score lower are more emotionally stable and more likely to have higher self-esteem and maintain resilience.
The next factor is extroversion. It refers to the intensity to which an individual seeks interaction with their social environment, and it is measured on an introversion-extroversion continuum. While introverts are quieter, shyer, part of smaller social circles, and intimidated being in large groups such as parties, extroverts, on the other hand, are sociable, talkative, and thrive in the company of others. They love being the center of attention.
Unlike extroversion, which consists of the pursuit of relationships, this next factor focuses on people's orientation and interactions with others. Agreeableness refers to how people tend to treat relationships with others. Agreeable individuals are described as soft-hearted, trusting, altruistic, and well-liked. They are helpful and sensitive to the needs of others. Scoring low in agreeableness is likened to antagonism, wherein individuals on the lower end of this broad spectrum are perceived as suspicious, manipulative, and uncooperative. They may be antagonistic when interacting with others.
The fourth factor of personality is openness to experience. This pertains to one's willingness to try new things, as well as engage in intellectual activities, or simply, the ability to think outside the box. A person who is open to experience is perceived as creative and prefers variety to routine. They value independence and are curious about their surroundings. Meanwhile, those that are closed off to experience often find it difficult to think creatively, are uncomfortable with change, and thus prefer routine.
The final factor of personality is conscientiousness, which refers to an individual's duty to regulate their impulse control and engage in co-directed behavior. It is measured by elements such as control, inhibition, and persistency of behavior. Scoring high in conscientiousness shows a greater tendency of being organized, disciplined, and goal-oriented. This denotes good impulse control, which helps in task completion. On the other hand, scoring low in conscientiousness is a sign of lack of direction. An individual may struggle with impulse control, leading to difficulty in task completion and the tendency to become more disorganized and dislike structure.
While most of us would most likely lie on the middle of the scale, there are those who would fully comply towards one pole. Those set on the center better adapt to both environments, however, would not prosper much in either. These descriptions of each typical characteristic allows us to determine the strengths that we hold, as well as positively impact or alter the approach we usually have on certain events or issues. Not only does this aid each individual discover their own truths, but it helps in the development of social behavior. The model, being well recognized in the scientific community, has been carried out in different clinical practices and built in several stages over the past decades. This former attempt to provide a comprehensive list of describing the important personality traits is now used as a basis on why one acts or feels a certain way by using a combination of scores of two extremes.
Generally, Robert McRae and Paul Costa's five-factor model of personality has led to a profound effect on personality research through summarizing people's traits into five dimensions, namely neuroticism on one's emotional security, extroversion on one's ability to interact socially, openness to experience on one's willingness for discoveries, agreeableness on one's behavior towards relationships, and conscientiousness on one's responsibilities or duties.
With this presently being a widely accepted practice in different areas of the world, our group agrees and believes in the validity of the theory. When we encounter the questioning of our own behaviors and thoughts, we seek ways to structure, see through, or attempt to gain an overview of them. McRae and Costa's model helps us reduce the complexity of this curiosity and enables us to focus on why we behave a certain way. However, this model does not define how we should think. It is merely a result of our active thought process. By taking all of these pieces together, we are able to find an estimate of how our values and past experiences shape our way of thinking. Indeed, we are the optimal judges of how well these descriptions are applied to us.